Hey guys, today we're going to talk about a really cool self-diagnostic feature in your 350Z or your G35. Now, it doesn't matter if you're a professional mechanic or a weekend warrior, when it comes to work on your vehicle, sometimes diagnostics is involved. Now, before I start this video, guys, please proceed with caution. This procedure is going to turn on the cooling fans, and those are very strong, and you could injure yourself if anything or anyone is near them. Modern vehicles like our 350Z over here have a lot of electronics and a body control module to control everything, so there's no replacement for using diagnostic tools like this. However, there are times where you might have to grab a buddy or something to help control devices to see what's going on. To begin this procedure, you're going to want to have the door open and start with the ignition off. The first step is to put the ignition to the run position. So we have accessory, then you have on. With ignition on, we can now hit the door pin 10 times. Turn off, turn it back on immediately. Now what you're gonna hear is you're gonna hear the horn honk, giving you confirmation that you've entered the diagnostic mode. So leave the ignition on the on position. When you do this procedure, you're gonna have to do it fairly fast. You have to go ignition on, hit the door pin 10 times, turn the ignition off, and turn it back on right away. So let's go ahead and do it. Horn honks, and leaving ignition on. Wipers are turning on. Parking lights are on right now. So wipers high. No one's in there. Parking lights on. Headlights. Cooling fans. Cooling fans on high. Now when you do this procedure, make sure everything's clear. Just go do it three times. And your hands are not in the way, nothing's in the way of the fans especially, because everything's going to turn on under the hood. Anything controlled by the BCM is basically going to turn on. Now there's a lot of clicking that was going on there, so it's basically activating so many electronics. Now if you're trying to test the lights, you'll also notice I have the xenon factory headlights here. When you put your hands on the headlight housing itself, when you hear those big clicks, it's setting itself for the high beams. Now during this procedure, the car will turn on the running lights, but it doesn't activate the brake lights. The brake lights are just on a solid switch on the brake pedal. The BCM does not control them. Now, what's interesting about doing diagnostics this way is it helps us test things whether they're upstream or downstream. So things are controlled under here by the PCM, the powertrain control module, or the BCM, the body control module. So you might be able to go to the fuse panel and test for power, test the relays. You can even go directly to the device and activate it directly. However, if there's maybe another break in the line for the control unit, or if the control unit's faulty, this test can help us figure it all out. Here's another quick tip for you guys. If you're using a tool like this to induce power, let's say we verify the fans or whatever, and we want to see if we can turn on the fan directly. Maybe there's a blown fuse, maybe there's a break in the line, and we want to test the motor itself. A lot of people will put the power probe in and then hit the switch. What happens though is it'll actually arc inside of it because you're transferring power over. The best way to do it is to hit the button first, then touch the device. What that will happen is, since you're already having voltage at the tip, so instead of the voltage traveling through, so you have ground at the tip, and then now you're going to induce voltage, it'll arc inside. Because voltage is already at the tip, it'll arc on the outside, and that's going to make this thing last a lot longer. I think this is a fantastic feature if you know what you're doing. First of all, there's a reason why they say always keep your hands clear and disconnect the negative terminal. You saw here, these fans can turn on whenever they want, and we activate them through this diagnostic mode. Well, there you guys go. I hope that this video helps you out diagnose things. Now, I've never had a car help me diagnose itself as far as turning things on. I thought that was pretty neat. So I'm usually used to using just diagnostic tools like this and an extra set of hands. So comment below, guys. Does this video help you? Do you think it's pretty cool? Let me know. Comment below.